Palpitation means awareness of the heart beating. Most cases are benign, but it could mean a serious arrhythmia. So, you need to recognize when to be concerned. Is it fast or slow? Regular or irregular? If slow and irregular, you're most likely dealing with extra beats. The patient may feel an odd sensation in the throat, or the need to cough, even a little breathless. But there shouldn't be symptoms of low output. In this setting, reassure the patient, get an ECG to confirm extra beats, and leave it at that. Do they have underlying heart disease? This is the most important question. The arrhythmia you're most worried about is ventricular tachycardia, or VT. VT is rapid and regular and usually brings low output symptoms. The patient may feel like passing out or they may appear pale. They may even collapse without warning. This can cause sudden death, and the people most at risk are those with abnormal pump function. Chest pain or breathlessness may be present, but are not specific. Even with normal coronary vessels, a relative blood supply and demand imbalance may exist. Therefore, these symptoms don't discriminate between ventricular tachycardia and less serious supraventricular rhythms, such as atrial fibrillation or atrial flutter. You should be able to recognize a typical vasovagal attack. This type of blackout is benign. There may be palpitation, but it is never rapid. There will always be some warning as sympathetic tone is withdrawn, usually lightheadedness with nausea. This is a time to reassure the patient rather than over-investigate. Other features of the history may give a clue to the type of arrhythmia. Sudden onset and offset is typical of reentrant tachycardias, such as atrial flutter or supraventricular tachycardia. Think of this arrhythmia like a light switch. Rapid irregular palpitation is most likely to be atrial fibrillation. Think of this arrhythmia like a sputtering car engine. Finally, you should investigate every potential arrhythmia with an ECG as soon as possible, ideally when palpitation is present. This will allow you to correlate the recorded rhythm with symptoms.